In this session, we are discussing time and space complexity. Time and space complexity will give us one estimate that how much time the program will take during its execution, and regarding the space complexity, how much space will it take during execution. Here the space means the space in the primary memory. So let us get the text here. So space complexity is defined as the process of determining a formula for prediction of how much memory space will be required for the successful execution of the algorithm. So how much space it will require during its runtime. The memory space we generally consider is the space of the primary memory, because we know that whenever a program executes, the program is to be loaded onto the primary memory. Then during execution, how much space will it occupy, that will be decided by the space complexity. Obviously, in case of space complexity, the number of instructions getting executed, the number of instructions residing in the algorithm, that will decide the space complexity. Time complexity. The time complexity is defined as the process of determining a formula for total time required towards execution of that algorithm. So during the execution of the algorithm, total time required, that will be decided in the time complexity. This calculation will be independent of implementation details and obviously the programming language. Actually, we are considering the time complexity of an algorithm. So that's why obviously it will be irrespective of the programming language selected for the implementation of the algorithm. But simply, if anyone says that what is the complexity of a program, we commonly consider this as the time complexity. Don't consider the program which will be occupying a very minimum space in the primary memory. That means the program which is having space complexity minimum will be also having the time complexity minimum. That is not the same, because a program might be containing, say, 10 instructions. Out of those 10 instructions, 8 lines are in a loop, and the loop will get executed for 100 number of times. Then actually, during the execution, the program is executing 8 into 100 plus 2, that is 802 number of instructions. So the memory space has got occupied only for 10 instructions, but during execution, it is actually executing 802 instructions, approximately whatever calculations I have made right now. So the time complexity of the program will be high. Asymptotic notations, they are used to make meaningful statements about the efficiency of the algorithms. So they will make some meaningful statements about the efficiency of the algorithm. These notations help us to make approximate but meaningful assumptions about the time and the space complexity. So here we are having mainly three asymptotic notations. One is the big O notation. So that is a big O. So it is known as the upper bound. That means the maximum complexity, time complexity, which will be suffered by this program is known as the, will be denoted by the big O notation. Big omega notation, that is the lower bound, that is the minimum time at least it will take. So that is the omega. will be denoting there is a big omega notation. And the last one is the big theta notation, will be denoting the tight bound. That means within the upper bound or lower bound, the bound will be mentioned. So that is my big theta notation. Let us suppose we are having n number of data, and I'm trying to search the one item and to search for one given item value within that set of data. Then what will be the minimum number of such required? I think that is one. If I get the search item at the very first place, then I shall say successful completion of the searching. What is the maximum search required? So I can find the data at the last, that is at the nth data will be the search item. Otherwise, after searching all n number of data, I am finding that the search item is not there. So in that case, how many searching did I do? N number of searching, and that is the upper bound. And what is the lower bound? One. And in case of tight bound, I can say that we can find this one at the n plus 1 whole by 2 searching will be required, or n by 2 searching will be required if I can get the data at the middle. So that is my, so in case of linear search, the worst case complexity or the upper bound will be our n, the best case complexity or the lower bound will be our 1, and the average case complexity or tight bound will be our n by 2. Now consider, let us suppose I want to find out the maximum of n number of data. In that case, just try to feel that to find out the maximum of n number of data, you are bound to traverse and compare and process and check all n data, then only you can tell that which is maximum. Might be true that the first data which is you are having at the very first place is the maximum, but you don't know until and unless that very particular data is being compared with the rest. You cannot tell, you cannot infer, you cannot declare that that is the maximum data. So that means in that case, the best case complexity, the average case complexity and the worst case complexity, all of them will be equal to n. So that is our complexity. So complexity here, we are denoting the time complexity. That means how many number of times the most prime operation within the algorithm is getting carried out. And that will give me the upper bound, that will give me the lower bound and the tight bound. I think we have discussed all this. In the next videos, we will be discussing this big O notation, big omega notation and big theta notation. Please watch those videos, because those videos will be in the continuation of this particular topic. Thanks for watching this one.